A lot of people are trying to analyze what is happening in the Ukraine right now and what Vladimir Putin is trying to accomplish. And we're hearing a great deal of media reports that Russia's advance is slower than expected. And the Ukrainian defense is staunch. And they're putting up such a fight that Russia is taking heavy losses. And as most of you know, that is for the purposes of propaganda, because the losses on the Ukrainian side are extremely heavy. And being a student of military tactics and history, also being a player of chess and other strategy games, I don't think Russia is actually taking the beating as the media and the early indications indicate. They're coming from the south, the east, the northeast, and the north, pushing in slowly. And when we take into account Putin's public reasons for invading Ukraine, outside of all the NATO stuff, there are three primary objectives. And for him to win the propaganda campaign at home, despite what we see with the protesters, and we'll get to that a little later on, when all this Ukrainian business is over, Putin will need to declare victories in these three areas. The first objective was to liberate two areas inside of Ukraine that voted to pull away. Whether they were puppet regimes there or not, that is not the argument. Second, it was to demilitarize the Ukraine. And third, and probably most important to him, was regime change. There are most assuredly other reasons Putin is doing this at this time, but for him to declare victory, for him to look good in front of the Russian people when it is all said and done, he has to obtain those three objectives. And before I go any further, ladies and gentlemen, I am not a supporter of Putin, and I am not a supporter of NATO. Largely, this is happening because the masters of reality want this to happen. In the Ukraine, they're arming everybody. Normal citizens are being armed so they can become targets of trained Russian military. The corrupt government in the Ukraine is convincing their citizens to take up arms to protect them. So when all these civilian casualties happen, even though these civilians were fighting the Russians, they will have a propaganda piece to play on all the news media for you, so that more of you will want to take up arms, even though you're not trained. So whatever Putin is doing here, in the end, it is going to help that depopulation goal that the masters of reality always wanted. Let's get into analyzing Putin's tactics here. If we're going with the goal stated earlier, and we put ourselves into his shoes, what we see happening early on is that he has sent in reconnaissance with force into these areas. To translate that into chess terms, he sent in his pawns and a few bishops. Most of his elite forces, or the rooks and the knights and the queen and anything else that he has up his sleeve, is still sitting back in their deployed locations. Up there in the north in Belarus, on the northeastern side of Russia, down in the southeastern side of Russia, and even in Crimea, most of the more experienced and potent weapons he has at his disposal are doing nothing or very little, while the pawns and the bishops are testing the waters on the defensive capabilities of the Ukrainian army and where their strong points are. At the very same time, in the very south region from Crimea, he has pushed up very successfully up into this waterway here. Now he has a natural barrier to protect himself from attack. If you move to the east, where he's made some pretty decent advances, they're slugging it out a little bit, but the direction of the military units are going for almost the same waterway, just the eastern part, moving north a bit where it's in the northeastern side, using pawns, mind you, and bishops, moving westward in the direction of this huge waterway. While all this is happening and he's making headway here, he's forcing the capital to go into siege mode or guerrilla warfare, and guaranteed the Ukrainian army needs to pull troops back to Kiev to help defend the city. And the attack on the city, it's effective enough. Mind you, I am going by what we all publicly know. There are a lot of things happening that are behind the scenes and not available for myself or for any of you. But judging by all this movement here that we do know about, I believe everything is going as planned for the Russians. In fact, with all these forces that haven't been deployed into the war zone, outside of the Crimea forces, who might be there to hold that ground in case some outside force wants to cause trouble, the rest of these forces either can go home, sit there, or advance. But as you can see, there's been a huge opening happening behind the lines, and that may be the plan. While all the forces of the Ukraine are being pushed back to the river where they could be slaughtered, effectively demilitarizing the Ukraine. Because once these other forces come in, what I suspect will be from this very northeastern region of the Ukraine through this main roadway here, which I suspect is very weakly guarded at this moment because of all the activity that they have to deal with the pawns and the bishops. So if the Russians unleash their rooks and their knights down this roadway, there will be very little resistance to deal with that incursion. All these pawns and bishops are pushing back the Ukrainian defenses. The knights and the rooks will have a clear path to cut off their retreat once they've been pushed against this river and there's going to only be the waterway till they get to these bridges. Of course, I don't have this information, but if he truly wants to demilitarize the Ukraine, I would suspect that all the bridges along that route, along this waterway right here, will be taken out. Most of the material that has been pushed into the Ukraine, ladies and gentlemen, most of it, not all of it, has been cannon fodder, old material. I've seen the footage. You can go to my Twitter page. None of this stuff is their A-list weapons. A lot of this is really old material getting taken. Now, some of it is, I guess, would be considered a tad more advanced with the helicopters. Why hasn't Russia just unleashed their entire air force? It's not that hard to. They could have air superiority already if they wanted to. Why haven't they? And they haven't chose to come in mass yet. Like I said earlier, what's happening right now, ladies and gentlemen, is a propaganda campaign from the West while Russia is using reconnaissance in force to push back the Ukrainian military, most likely bottle them up against all the waterways, and that's where they're going to crush them. And that will achieve a vast majority of the demilitarization of the Ukraine. At the same time, whether they crush Kiev, which I'm not sure they want to just bomb it into non-existence, or they just force a surrender or whatever, their objectives of decapitating or regime change is their third goal, which means that will come last after they've liberated the two areas, which looks like they have, and then the demilitarization of the Ukrainian army was second on that list. And this, what appears to be slow advance by the Russians, looks more like they're pushing the Ukrainian forces into a trap. And when they're bottled up, that's most likely when we'll see Russia really unleash their military. And their air force is kind of like their queen. They've only made little runs. But when I want to take out pieces of my opponent playing chess or any other strategic game, I try to bottle up those forces myself so that I can move in with a killing blow and sacrificing a few pawns. And to Russia, to 3,000, 4,000, 17-year-old, 18-year-old boys in light to medium armor vehicles, those are just pawns and bishops, and they'd be willing to sacrifice a lot of pawns and a lot of bishops. That's how I see it, ladies and gentlemen. He's going to leave the Ukrainian forces that are in the eastern part of the country with nowhere to run, and he really hasn't used many of his big guns. And once those three objectives are obtained, I have a feeling he'll declare victory unless we have some sort of intervention or provocation from NATO, and then the whole ball game is off. Also at home, ladies and gentlemen, he's finding out the opposition and taking care of it with the protests. And to do all that, he's barely showed his hand. With this 98th Airborne here, right off of Poland, he's also getting extremely great reconnaissance on NATO deployment on that potential future front. So from what I see here, I believe Putin is doing exactly what he planned, and it's going pretty much according to the way he expected it to. Of course, in war, there's always developments you have to be prepared for that arise. That's it for now. If I have more thoughts in the future, I'll be sure to give them to you.